students, welcome to the chapter Vital Statistics. In previous session, we have discussed the first reproduction rate, that is gross reproduction rate or GRR. See, the gross reproduction rates takes into account current fertility but not current mortality. To take into account the factor of mortality in measuring population growth, we use net reproduction rates. So that is, in today's class we are going to study the second measure, that is NRR. Okay, so that is net reproduction rate. So NRR is defined as the average number of daughters that would be born to a female if she passed through her lifetime conforming to the age specific fertility and mortality rates of a given year. See, reproduction rate is the number of female children surviving till their reproductive ages, or number of female children to one woman as she passes through childbearing age. And NRR cannot exceed GRR for the reason that in its calculation we also take into account mortality. Both the rates will be equal when all the newly born daughters reach the childbearing age. So NRR is calculated by the following formula. NRR equals I into summation WSFR into S, where I stands for the magnitude of the age class, and WSFR means FBX divided by FBX into 1000. So this means, so how to find WSFR? The formula of WSFR is female births divided by female population into 1000. So S stands for survival rates. It is given in the example. So next, interpretation. First interpretation is, if NRR per woman is exactly 1, it indicates that on the basis of current fertility and mortality rates, a group of newly born females will exactly replace itself in the new generation. That is, the population will be constant. So this means, when finding the NRR, if NRR is equal to 1, NRR per woman is equal to 1, the population will be constant. The second interpretation is, if NRR per woman is below 1, it indicates decreasing population. The third interpretation is, if NRR is more than 1, the population will going to increase. So then what are the merits of NRR then? The first merit is, it takes into account current fertility and current mortality. See, it is advantage. In calculation of NRR, it considers both current birth rate and current death rate. And second merit is, it will show a tendency of increase or decrease in population. See, NRR will show the current trend of population, whether it is increasing or decreasing. So then what are the drawback or demerits of NRR then? The first demerit is, it assumes constant rates of fertility and mortality over a generation. In actual life, both these rates go on changing. So it is one of the major drawback of NRR here. See, NRR, it considers a constant rates of fertility and mortality. If you go for 10 year or 20 years back, the fertility rate for per woman is either 5 or 6. If you see present generation, means in the year 2020, the fertility rate per woman is 1 or 2. So like this, generation to generation, the fertility rate goes on changes, and also for mortality, means death rate. So if you go for 20 years back, the death rate is high. But now the death rate is totally reduced, because in 20 years back the medical facility is not advanced. but now medical facilities very advanced, so the death rate is less. So that's why it assumes only constant rates of fertility and mortality over a generation, because these rates goes on changes as the generation changes, these rates goes also changes. Next demerit of NRR is the population of a country may become depleted more by migration than by declining birth rate. So this means the population of a country may become reduced more by migration than by decreasing birth rate. And the third demerit is it cannot be used for forecasting future population changes. Using NRR, we can't forecast the future population changes. Let us solve examples on NRR. The first example, calculate net reproduction rate from the following data given below. First column, age group is given. Second column, female population. The third column, female births. The last column, survival rates. So for this example, we have to find NRR or net reproduction rate. So solution, as you know, the formula of NRR is I into summation WSFR into S. So this means to find NRR, what we require? We require WSFR. So after finding WSFR, survival rate is already given in the example. Just we multiply WSFR into S. So this means first we have to find out WSFR. So as we know, the formula of WSFR is female births divided by female population. So WSFR for the age of 15 to 19 is 50 divided by 3000 into 1000 is 16.66. Next, WSFR for the age group 20 to 24 is 400 divided by 2500 into 1000 is equal to 160. Next, WSFR for the age group 25 to 29 is 300 divided by 2200 into 1000 is equal to 136.66. Next, WSFR for the age group 30 to 34 is 100 divided by 2000 into 1000 is equal to 50. Next, WSFR for the age group 35 to 39 is 60 divided by 1800 into 1000 is equal to 33.33. Next, WSFR for the age group 40 to 44 is 30 divided by 1500 into 1000 is equal to 20. The WSFR for the age group 45 to 49 is 10 divided by 1200 into 1000 is equal to 8.33. So these are the WSFR values. So now to calculate NRR, we want WSFR into S. So these are the WSFR values. We just multiply with the survival rates. Survival rate is nothing but S. So 16.66 into 0.9 is 14.99. 160 into 0.9 is 144. 136.66 into 0.8 is 109.08. Next, 50 into 0.8 is 40. 33.33 into 0.8 is 26.66. 20 into 0.8 is 16. And the last one, 8.33 into 0.7 is 5.83. So these are the WSFR into S values. After finding these values, we want the total of this. So after adding all these values, summation WSFR into S is 356.56. So now to substitute this, I is 5, that is constant. Summation WSFR into S is 356.6. So now it becomes, the final answer is NRR is equal to 1782.8 female births per 1000 women. So let us solve NRR per woman. Okay, NRR per woman is 1782.8 divided by 1000 is 1.7828 female births. So this means here NRR is greater than 1. So then the comment is, since this rate is greater than 1, the population is increasing. So let us solve one more example on NRR. See, this is 10 marks example. In this example, we have to find GRR and as well as NRR, both we have to find. So example is, calculate NRR and GRR from the following data given below. First column age group is given, second column female population, third column female births, the last column survival rates. Okay, so in this question both we have to find GRR and NRR. Solution, as we know the formula of GRR is I into summation WSFR. To find out GRR, we want summation WSFR total. So then first we need to find WSFR. So first we will find the WSFR values. So the formula of WSFR is female births divided by female population into 1000. So first we will find WSFR for the age of 15 to 19 is 20 divided by 1600 into 1000 is equal to 12.50. WSFR for the age group 20 to 24 is 30 divided by 1700 into 1000 is equal to 17.64. Next, WSFR for the age group 25 to 29 is 100 divided by 1800 into 1000 is equal to 55.55. Next, WSFR for the age group 30 to 34 is 80 divided by 1750 into 1000 is equal to 45.71. So like this we have to find WSFR for all the age groups. So these are the WSFR values. To find out the GRR, so after finding the WSFR values we want the total of this. So summation WSFR is 144.6. so now you substitute in the formula. So summation WSFR is 5 into 144.6. so this becomes GRR is equal to 723 female births per 1000 women. So now second question is, we have to find NRR. So the formula of NRR is I into summation WSFR into S. So already we have to find the WSFR into S values. So we know the WSFR into S values. Summation WSFR into S total is 138.8519. So now you multiply with the 5. So 5 into 138.8519 is equal to, NRR is equal to 694.2595 female births per 1000 women. Thank you.